Now, you may be wondering if you already have another external website that you're using for your domain, and you're only using Kajabi to deliver your course and create your landing pages, how do you set that up? So what we're going to talk about now is creating a subdomain of your existing domain name. So let's pretend that the reinventionrevolution.com is an external WordPress site. Well, if that's the case, I don't want the www to point to Kajabi. I still want my A record to control that the reinventionrevolution.com points to my WordPress site. However, what I want to do is create a subdomain. And because this is going to be, Kajabi is going to be the home to courses and memberships, maybe that subdomain, I might want it to be courses.thereinventionrevolution.com, members.thereinventionrevolution.com. But because I'm going to have courses and a membership, I might want to just call it programs. So in that situation, with our CNAME, instead of having www point to endpointmykajabi.com, I'm going to edit that and remove www, and I'm going to put in my subdomain, programs, just like that. Now, we change that CNAME to show our subdomain, but we want to make sure we still have a CNAME for our www. So I'm going to add a record. That record is going to be a CNAME. It's going to be www, and the target is going to be this A record, also known as the root, and the at sign is what is designated for this A record. And I'm going to click save. So now what we have, we still have our A record, the domain name pointing to wherever our WordPress site is. We have our www still pointing to the domain that is pointing to the WordPress site. But we now have programs as a subdomain pointing to Kajabi. So that means over here under our custom domain, you know, we would have to start it over again. We would put programs.thereinventionrevolution.com as the custom domain that we want associated with our Kajabi site.